Today we are going to solve another two examples of the binomial distribution. So watch this video lecture till end so that you will get a confidence for solving the binomial distribution problem. So let us start for the first problem. An unbiased coin is tossed 6 times. Find the probability of getting 2 heads, 3 heads and at least 3 heads. In a previous video, we have solved such type of examples. So this type of example is very simpler to solve by binomial distribution. So here the data is the toss 6 times. That means the number of trials equal to 6. Now we have to find the probability of getting 2 heads. Before that, we should calculate the probability of getting heads in a single trial. So the probability of getting 8s in a single trial is half. So this is the probability of success. As we have seen in the previous video, probability of success is half. So probability of failure is 1 minus p, because p plus q is 1. So q is 1 minus p, so 1 minus 1 half, and that is q also half. Now let us take first event for getting probability of getting 2 heads. Probability of getting 2 heads. That means our R is 2. So by binomial distribution, what is the formula of binomial distribution? That is P R is equal to N C R into P raised to R into Q raised to N minus R. Now put the values here. R is 2 heads, so R is equal to 2. Number of trials are 6, C 2. Probability of success is half raised to R is 2. Probability of failure, that is also half, 6 minus 2. So here we will get 6C2 means 6 factorial upon 2 factorial, 6 minus 2 factorial. So into 1 into 1 upon 4 into 1 half raised to 4. So by solving it, we'll get p by 2 is equal to, now 6 factorial, that means 6 into 5 into 3 into 2 into 1 upon 2 factorial means 2 into 1, and 4 factorial means 4 into 3 into 2 into, sorry, here 4 is remaining, 4 into 3 into 2 into 1. So this 4 factorial will get cancelled. This is 3. So we'll get 15 into 1 by 4 into 1 by 16. So we'll get 15 upon 60. So by calculating, we will get 15 divided by 64, that is 0.234. So probability of getting 2 heads is 0.234. So at this stage, you can calculate this 6C2 Here our first step is complete. 6C2. So our formula is 6 factorial upon 2 factorial upon n minus r. So 6 minus 2, that is 4 factorial. So we can write this 6 into 5 into 4 factorial, so that this 4 factorial will get cancelled and remaining is only 6 into 5 upon 2 into 1. So we will get 15. So in this way it is very simpler. So you can put directly 4 factorial. Now let us take the second event, and that is probability of getting 3 heads. That means here data is r is equal to 3, n is equal to 6, p is half and q is half, because we have already calculated it. Now by binomial distribution, so first of all we will write the formula. PR is equal to NCR into P raised to R into Q raised to N minus R. Now put the values of R, P, Q and N. So here R is 3. So 6C3, probability of success is half, raised to R is 3. Probability of failure is also half, 6 minus 3, that is also 3. So 6 3 3, that means 6 factorial upon 3 factorial upon 6 minus 3 factorial, that means 3 factorial. So we can into 1 upon 8 into 1 upon 8. Now we can write this 6 into 5 into 4 into factorial 3. So this factorial 3 into 3 factorial 3 into 2 into 1. So this will get cancelled. This 3 into 2, 6. So 6 will get cancelled and we will get 20. So we will get 20. So is equal to, PR is equal to 20 upon 64. By simplification we will get 5 upon 16. So probability of getting 3 heads is 5 upon 16. We can take into point 5.16, that is 0.3125. So probability always lies between 0 and 1. So probability of getting 3 heads is 0.31%. So now third case is, that is third event, probability of getting at least 3 heads. At least 3 head means we have to take 6 times. So at least 3 means 3, 4, 5 and 6. So probability of 3 plus probability of 4 plus probability of 5 plus probability of 6. But this calculation is very difficult or lengthy. So instead of this, we will calculate probability of 0, 1, 2 and it will subtract from 1. So this equal to 1 minus probability of 0 plus probability of 1 plus probability of 2. So our one calculation will be avoided. So here now R is 0, 1, 2. So you can calculate separately P0, P1, P2 and then take addition and then subtraction from 1. We will put directly here also probability of R is equal to at least 3 is equal to, so 1 minus probability of 0 plus probability of 1 plus probability of 2. So 1 minus, now here R is equal to 0, here R is equal to 0, here R is equal to 1 and R is equal to 2. So accordingly we can calculate separately. So trials are 6, N, C, R, P raised to R, Q raised to N minus R, that is 6 plus. Now R is 1, so 6C 1 half raised to 1 into half raised to 6 minus 1, that is 5 plus. Now R is equal to 2, so 6C 2 half raised to 2 and half raised to 6 minus 2, that is 4. So 1 minus 6C0. Now 6C0 is always 1. If we calculate this, we will get 1. So 1 into 1 half raised to 0, that is also 1, into 1 by 2 raised to 6. So 1 by 2 means 0.5 raised to 6, and that is 0.0156 plus 6C1. So it is 6 into half into 1 half raised to 5, that is 1 upon 32. So 0.5 raised to 5, that is 0.0312 plus 6C2. Now 6C2, 6 shift NCR 2, that is 15. 15 into 1 by 4 into 1 by 16. So we will get 1 minus in bracket 0.0156 plus 3 into 0.0312. So it is 0.0936 plus 15 upon 64. So 15 upon 64, that is 0.234. So take addition of this. So 1 minus in bracket 0.0156 plus 0.0936 plus 0.2234. So we'll get 0.6568. So this is the probability of getting at least 3 heads. So in this way we can calculate the example of the binomial distribution. Now let us take second example. So the example is, if 20% of bolts produced by a machine are defective, then determine the probability that out of 4 bolts drawn, first one is defective and second one is at most 2 are defective. Now here the probability of defective bolts taken as a P. Probability of defective bolts and that is P. So probability is 20%. So P is equal to 20%, that is 20/100. So that is 0.2. Now calculate non-defective probability of non-defective piece bolts. Q is equal to 1 minus P, so that is 1 minus 0.2 and that is 0.8. So P is 0.2 and Q is 0.8. Now we will take 4 bolts drawn, that means 4 trials are taken. So n equal to 4. So according to the binomial theorem, the formula is PR is equal to NCR P raised to R into Q raised to N minus R. So take first case, and that is 1 is defective. That means 1 bolt is defective. So first event is probability of getting 1 bolt is defective. 1 bolt is defective out of 4. So here R is what? 1 and N is 4. So probability of R equal to 1 is equal to NCR, that is 4C1, probability 0.2, that is P raised to 1 into Q is 0.8 raised to N minus 1, that is 4 minus 1. So here we will get 4C1. Now 4C1, in last example we have seen 4C1 or 6C1, so its value is N, that is 4. 0.2 raised to 1, that is 0.2 into 0.8 raised to 3. So here by calculating we will get 4 into 0.2 into 0.8 cube, that is 0.4096. So probability of getting 1 bolt defective is 0.40. Now second case is, at the most 2 are defective. So we have to find out the probability defective. So here R is what? R will be at most, that means R 0, R is 1 and R is 2. Now it is very simple that we have to calculate probability of 0 plus probability of 1 and probability of 2. So we will get directly the probability of at most 2 are defective. So probability of R equal to at the most 2 equal to probability of 0 plus probability of 1 plus probability of 2. So first point out probability of 0. That means R is equal to 0, here R is equal to 1, and here R is equal to 2, and then summation. So it is, now n is what? N is 4. N is 4. So 4C0, P is 0.2, so raised to 0 into 0.8 raised to 4 minus 0, that is 4, plus P1, that is R is equal to 1, so 4C1 into 0.2 raised to 1 into 0.8 raised to 4 minus 1, that is 3, plus 4C2 into 0.2 raised to 2 into 0.8 raised to 4 minus 2, that is 2. So 4C1 is always 1, 0.2 raised to 0, that is also 1, into 0.8 raised to 4. So 0.8 raised to 4, that is 0.4096, plus 4C1 is 4, into 0.2 into 0.8 raised to 3. So 0.8 raised to 3 is 0.512, plus 4C2. So 4C2, that is 6, into 0.2 raised to 2, that is 0.04, into 0.8 square, that is 0.64, is equal to 0.4096 plus 4 into 0.2 into 0.512, and that is 0.4096 plus 6 into 0.04 into 0.64, so that is 0.514. So its answer is 0.9732. So probability of at most 2 are defective is 0.97, at most 2. These 2 examples were asked in the examination. Now there are 3 examples for the practice. So you try to solve these 3 examples of binomial theorem, binomial distribution, so that you will get the confidence about the solving binomial distribution. Thank you for watching this video. Be with us. So in next video we will study the Poisson's distribution. Thank you for watching this.